Hi, everybody. Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Tonight's easy pace of warm-ups, over. Better buckle those chin straps. SEC action about to start. Thanks for joining us here on the NCAA College Football pregame show. Now let's send it out to Brad and Kirk for all the action. We'll see you at the half.
Sixth largest on-campus stadium in the entire country, the site for this college football showdown.
And that's time for the coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything.
Teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. And this season is officially underway. Gibson from the three. At the 30. He's knocked out of bounds.
At about the 39-yard line.
Auburn's offensive staff, they really build things around this guy, and they know that they can be confident in what he can do all game long.
Yeah, I think they trust in all of his abilities. And the big thing also is he avoids those silly mental mistakes. He does not line up in the wrong position. He's not going to turn the wrong way. More importantly, he's not going to miss out on a blitz on pass protection. So he's really just a total package, very consistent, very reliable running back that this team utilizes.
Nice run, and he's brought down. At the 48-yard line, a 2-yard run by the halfback.
That'll bring up fourth and one.
Lloyd is the punter. And he's tackled at the 24. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. Fires that quickly, incomplete. From their own 24-yard line, it's second down. Now he tries to buy some time. And he shoved out of bounds at the 37.
Hey, sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
And he's hit before he can go anywhere.
That's good for a gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Hands it off. And they'll get him in the backfield.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. And it looks like they're going to bring everyone in tight for this one. They give to the tailback. They tackle him there, and he's still going to be short. Jones takes it to 21. He's pushed out of bounds at the 33. Every drive's important in a tie game. I look for both sides to come out with some urgency. Give to the tailback, and he's met in the backfield.
Loss of 3 yards on the play. That brings up second and 13.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 30. They'll bring him down
at about the 43-yard line.
The reason why it's so crucial to be able to run effectively like this is it keeps the defense guessing. They have no idea whether you're passing or running, even if you need medium to long-range yards.
They try to run up the middle, but met in the backfield.
No gain. That'll bring up second and 11.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That's a gain of 6 on the play. That'll make it 35.
Tight left, tight left. Four down. Check my 12. Easy. Over.
And he throws it away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Butler, the return man. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation.
But the defense is fired up, responding and reacting to that sack. Not only did they get the quarterback, but they hit him and hit him hard. I think that can really create some confidence for this defense. The next time this quarterback drops back to throw, you got to be thinking he's going to be a little bit gun-shy and concerned about the pressure that these defense is putting on
him. From their own 15-yard line, second down. Quick strike, and he drops it.
Third, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it third and 15.
And he's leveled at the 30-yard line.
I think he was going to go to his tight end the whole way, but the defense didn't expect it. Sometimes those big guys can fool defenders into thinking they're blocking.
First and 10, ball on the 30-yard line. Washington gets a ball left side. And he's tackled at the 41-yard line.
Call it a gain of 11 yards. That makes it first and 10.
We've played one quarter. This one's scoreless. Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play. And they make the stop at the 43.
That's a gain of 2 on the play. That makes it second and 8.
From their own 43-yard line, second down.
Mike 5. Big down.
Small, on play action. It's a fumble. Looks like the offense has it. He's going to try and scramble.
The ball pops free. They fall on it.
Dives forward.
So it's the cornerback that comes up with a fumble, and this ball will change hands.
Fumbles will absolutely drown an offense. It's hard to get into a rhythm when you make mistakes like that.
They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. From their own 46-yard line. Second down.
Ready!
Tackle around the 41-yard line. He's under some heat. He airs it out. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it.
Boy, Brad, this guy drops an interception. And what's ironic about that from going to the meetings the other day is that this guy's been telling the coaches he wants to play some wide receiver. You wonder why you're not playing wide receiver? Because you can't catch the ball as a defensive back.
Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. He's taken down at the 39-yard line. There's a strike complete, and he's taken down at the 39.
Hayden brings him down at the 39-yard line. That makes it
fourth. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. They come out on an empty backfield. Looking for his man, incomplete. There's a missed opportunity by the offense.
That's a big-time stop here by the defense. I know we're only in week one, but this defense looks like they're in midseason form.
The offense comes out of the field, and they're hoping to avoid the similar fate that killed their last drive.
One general rule in any game is to hold on to the ball. If you're in the negative in the turnover department, your chances of winning decrease exponentially.
Here's the pass, broken up. From their own 39-yard line, it's second down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. Tackle made at the 36. They lose 3 yards there.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
From their own 36-yard line, it's third down. Set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. Cunningham awaits the snap. Taken down at the 30. Both offenses have played it pretty close to the vest so far in this one.
Yeah, because they've been so conservative, it's made it pretty easy for both of these defenses to be pretty dominant. Let's see an offense open it up and take a few chances.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Zips it to the back. He's tackled at the 43-yard line.
I tell you what, this defense better start to get pressure on the quarterback. They're giving him way too much time back there to throw the football.
receiver, and he can't make the grab.
Matthews, the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 43. Quick shot, the defender tips it away.
He showed you some of his natural athletic ability following the play and making a really quick stab to knock away the pass.
Fires it quickly. They can't connect. Incomplete.
Matthews, the intended receiver on the play. That'll make it fourth and 10.
Lloyd is waiting for the snap. Butler fields it at the 17. He's tackled at the 26-yard line. Well, if you're a fan of old-school smash-mouth football, you got to love this one.
Or if you're a fan of just sloppy offense, this has been bad for both teams. Let's see who can get things going here.
This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Tack on any yardage.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch, that's fun to see.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. He's on the run. Knocked out of bounds at the 36-yard line. Slings it. Brought down at the 29-yard line. And that play could have gone for six.
Oh, boy, you're right. And all week long, this secondary did a lot of talking about how they were going to dominate these receivers. I think this is time that they step up and prove it on the field. Forget about talking trash. Let's see how they react after giving up that big play.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Here's the halfback on the screen. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. That's a 6-yard loss.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
Florida is going to have to use their second time out of the half. Second and 15. Ball on the 35. He's scrambling. And down he goes around the 34-yard line. They'll bring him down right around the 28-yard line. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. So at the end of the half, no score here.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollock and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. A tight, hard-hitting, low-scoring affair.
Great affair. This is
right.
You can say it like it is.
This is right in your wheelhouse, Pollock. I mean, this is exactly in your comfort zone.
No, absolutely. I mean, you like to see people flying around. You like to see defenses dictating to offenses and make them play on our terms. And it's fun to watch. It's something that every great defense prides themselves on tackling. You know, you didn't see very many missed tackles in the first half that led to big plays. And try to limit those big plays. And when they do get down towards the red zone, make people kick field goals. And that's how you see dominant defenses year in, year out. And that's what we're seeing today.
That's going to do it at halftime. Just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, brother. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk takes the second half.
Welcome back, everybody. Second half action about to begin. Bird from the 5. At the 30. Tackle made at the 32-yard line. I think it says something about the quality of the preparation of both teams that we're into the third quarter and nobody's been able to pull away. Both sides seem to know what to expect. Slings it. Loose football. And no one can get it. It bounces out of bounds. So a big momentum shift could be in the making here as we take a look at the possible fumble. They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
After reviewing the play, The ruling on the field is reversed.
Well, after seeing the replay, it was apparent that his knee was down before he lost the ball.
Yep. Those guys in the booth aren't perfect, but they got it right this time.
From their own 34-yard line, it's second down. He's scrambling. He's at midfield, and he's tackled at the 46. Tailback brought down for a loss. From the 47-yard line, second down. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. He's out of bounds around the 42-yard line.
Third down.
Man left, man left.
Got his back, but he can't hang on. Jones will be the return man. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Now's when you start to approach each drive thinking that if you take the lead, then the momentum you gain feels that much more powerful. Gains his way to the 29-yard line.
That's a deep one. That brings up second and nine.
They got him for a loss.
Loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll bring up third and two.
Three down. Mike 12. Ready?
Ready?
Rocky 95.
Hot.
makes it to the 37. Wants to go long and does. And he hauls it in deep downfield. And they make the stop around the 30-yard line. Second and 10. Ball on the 30. Throws left. The running back's got it. Tackle around the 19-yard line. Forward to about the 16.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven. Left.
Four down. Mike 12. Easy. Eagle.
He makes it to the 15-yard line.
That's a gain of one on the play. That'll bring up third and six.
Quick toss. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. Auburn is looking to go up by three. He gets it up, and it's through the uprights. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. It's fielded at the two. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line. Auburn's coaching staff will go out tonight, and I think the offensive coordinator should buy the defensive coordinator his meal.
Well, the defense has been great. There's no doubt about it. But I just think that the offense that they're facing, they've just been so conservative, so predictable. It's made it very easy for this defense to have a dominant game.
He scrambled. Quarterback's going to run it, and he's got room to work. He's taken down at the 32.
That makes it first and 10.
First and 10. Ball on the 32.
Four down. Mike 5.
And he's shoved out of bounds at the 33-yard line. Tackles him hard. That's the 47.
Stevenson's on the tackle at the 47-yard line. First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Gains his way to the 43-yard line.
Call the game 10 yards. First down.
He's got another one, and he's level at the 40-yard line. But he didn't have much of a chance on that play.
Boy, this defense has a lot of speed. They're all over him by the time he caught the ball.
Second and seven.
Ball on the 40. He's going to try and scramble. He's brought down in the open field.
That's good for a gain of 8 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Tight right, tight right.
Four down,
Mike 5, Mike 5, Mike 5.
So at the end of the third quarter, the Tigers lead it 3-0. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action.
Three down, Mike 5.
Three down, stand ready.
He's at the 20, and he's taken down at the 16.
16 yards. First down.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Tries to buy some time. He gets sacked on the play. It's the ninth play of the drive. Scrambling around, and he's going to be sacked.
Well, we talked all week with these coaches, and even when we met with them yesterday out of practice, they told us there's big concerns about facing these defensive ends. They thought that they might be able to hold up against it, maybe get the ball out of the pocket a little bit quicker, maybe use running backs and tight ends to help with double teams on the outside. But right now, whatever they thought they might be able to do, we better get back to that drawing board because these defensive ends are just too quick.
Is out to the tailback on the screen. That's a great tackle at the 10-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 11 yards. That'll bring up fourth and
it's fourth down. This isn't much more than an extra point. The kick is up, and he's got it. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
Let's check in on what's going on in Berkeley. And for California, they've dropped two straight. The Wildcats get the W, 31-23.
3-3 game here. Looks like they're ready for the kick.
Gibson needs to return.
Gibson takes it at the 8, gets out to about the 21. 4 yards have been tough to come by for both these teams.
But it's been ugly to watch. The only thing you can really say is at least it's competitive still in the fourth quarter.
You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. Zips it to the tight end. And he is drilled at the 30-yard line.
Richard makes the tackle. That brings up second and
12.
And he throws it away. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Just under 3 to go in regulation. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
That brings him second and goal.
Mike 12.
Hands off.
Check
down.
He's tackled at the 48. Made
around the 39-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
They go with a run, and he brought down in the backfield.
Really nice play by the defensive lineman. I like this guy's size and instincts.
So it's third down, and they've got about 2 yards to go. Straight up the middle, and he'll lose yardage.
You know, these backwards plays can have a psychological impact. It can damage a team's confidence if it keeps happening.
Lloyd can pin him deep in their own territory with a good punt here. Well, here we go, Herbie. You got to love it. Final few minutes. It's crunch time.
Love to get into the fourth quarter with the game still yet to be determined. We'll find out who's going to make a play to win this thing.
This is when things get a little prickly. You need your playmakers to really come through here. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 18.
Two down. Mike five.
Fires it out. They'll bring him down at the 34.
That's good for a gain of 16 yards. First down.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 34. Quick throw. He goes out of bounds. Right around the 38-yard line.
That makes it second and six.
Man left.
Down at the 23.
That's good for being 39 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Quick throw to the tight end. There he goes. And down he goes at the 9-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Not today.
Under a minute left. Good outside run there. Florida will have one timeout remaining. Washington comes away with 5 yards on the carry. That brings up a second and goal. Ball on the 4. And he hits him hard at the 1-yard line. He's on the run. Decides to take it himself, and he's got it. Touchdown.
Shh.
They didn't snap the ball in time.
Delayed game. Offense.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. It was an 8-play, 82-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result. So our score, 10-3. I wouldn't be surprised if they just squib it here. He's to the 20, and he's taken down at the 25. Even in a game this close, I think it's going to take something very unexpected to change the outcome. But that doesn't mean it won't happen.
Oklahoma.
And he's tackled at the 38. Auburn will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 38-yard line.
Well, you never know what can happen in college football, so I wouldn't be surprised by anything here. Either way, it should be exciting.
Well, neither team could muster much of an offense today. It's final. 10-3, Gators. That's going to do it for this presentation of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, this is Brad Nessler saying goodbye.